Completions let us provide a prompt to an AI and get a response. There's a lot you can do with completions, from finishing sentences, writing poetry, or generating new ideas. Hi, my name's Swanee Bryson. Today we're going to look at OpenAI's completion API and see how it can be used in both the terminal and in Go. First, we'll go through a quick rundown of how OpenAI's APIs work. Next, we're going to look at the completions API in the command line. And finally, we're going to write our own completion assistant in Go. So OpenAI's APIs are made of stateless HTTP requests. You basically send a request and then get a JSON response back. To use these APIs, you need to provide an authentication token. To get this, create a login at openai.com, and from here you can generate a token under your user profile. It's important to know that these APIs aren't free, but when you sign up, you will get some trial credit. So in the terminal, I'm going to export OpenAI key and make that equal to the key that I generated earlier. And now I'm going to use the HTTP API with curl https://api.openai.com/v1/completions. And then in a new line, I'm going to add a header which contains content type application/json, and then I need to add another header for authorization. Here we are going to say bearer, and then put in our OpenAI key. And next we can put in the JSON payload that we want to send, which basically contains our request. So in here I'm going to go with model text DaVinci 003, which is commonly used for completions. And then we're going to add a prompt. I'm going to say, write a haiku about a ninja and a cat. And finally, I'm going to add another field called max tokens. Max tokens is basically optional, but if you don't provide enough, it won't give you a complete answer. And that's going to be the end of our request JSON. And the response is going to be in JSON too. And I want to parse that nicely to the command line. So I'm going to pipe that into Python 3 and then json.tool. And if we call this, we get a haiku, the ninja and the cat, a silent team creeps in dark night, not even the moon knows. I'm not sure that's exactly a haiku, but it's pretty close. So you might notice this choices array here. One option that we do have is to generate more than one choice from the AI. So what we want to do inside the request is add another field. This field is called n for n choices. I'm just going to put 3 in here. And if we call that, now we have 3 different poems: silent ninja moves, matching kitties every step, etc. Another control that we have is temperature. And basically, temperature can be a value between 0 and 2, 1 being the default. A temperature of 2 is very, very random, which means that we'll have a lot of variety in our responses, but not all of them will be a good match to our prompt. And a temperature of 0 is almost not random at all, but should be a very good match to our prompt. So if I say temperature 0, for example, we get 3 haikus, but they're all actually the same haiku because there's pretty much no randomness going on here. But they are all poems about ninjas and cats. If we say temperature 2, I'd expect not to see any actual haikus. It's going to be super random and not exactly a great match to our prompt. Here we are. Some of these don't even really make sense. So we get some interesting outputs, and that's kind of what happens when we increase the temperature too much. Next, we're going to write an assistant in Go using the completions API. So I'm going to jump in here and go mod init to create our project. Then we're going to go code main.go, and I'll give it the package name main and create a main function. Next, I'm going to create a client with C is equal to openai.newClient. And then here we need to pass our API key, so I'm going to go os.getenv and then grab our OpenAI key environment variable. Next, I'm going to go response error is equal to our client.createCompletion, and in here it takes two arguments. The first is a context, and I don't want to cancel this call, so I'm just going to go with a background context. And then the second argument is going to be our request, so I'm going to go openai.completionRequest, and the first field that I want to fill is the model OpenAI GPT-3 DaVinci, and we'll go with DaVinci 3. I also want to specify max tokens, so I'm going to go with 1024. And the next field is the prompt, and I want this to be user input. So the way I'm going to do this is go strings.join and basically join the command line arguments to this program. So to do that, I'm going to go os.args, and I'm just going to grab all the args after the first one, and then I'm going to join them with a space. And that's all the arguments I need for my request for now. So next I'm going to say if error does not equal nil, then we should panic with that error. And then finally I'm going to say for I choice is equal to range of response.choices. Then I'm going to call format.printf and pass in a number and a string and pass in I and choice.txt. If I save this and jump into the terminal, and now I can run this with go run, and my prompt is going to be finish the sentence, never gonna, and if I go enter, the answer is give you up. So we can also adjust temperature and the number of responses just like we did with the curl command. To do this, we jump into that request and we can say n is equal to 2, for example, and we can go temperature. I want it a little bit more random but not too crazy, so I'll say 1.7. And if we jump back into the command line and call the exact same prompt again, we're going to get option 0 is give you up. The other option is give you up dot 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 never gonna let you down, which are still pretty reasonable responses. So you now have your own personal AI, which you can send prompts to and it will send you responses. This is pretty neat, but each prompt and response are entirely self-contained. If you want something a little bit more conversational, I'd suggest checking out my OpenAI chat video. I've been Hwani Bryson, happy prompting, and I'll see you later.